Dear experts, distinguished guests and fellow teachers, I am Yu Qingmei, an English teacher from Haitong Primary School, Pudong New Area, Shanghai. Today, my topic is online English teaching in Shanghai during the pandemic, a study on how to maximize the English teaching efficacy. First, I'd like to introduce my school. My school is established in 1998. It introduced foreign taught English courses in 1999, being one of the first public schools in Shanghai to do so and lasting for the longest period of time. In 2000, the school carried out an experiment of bilingual teaching in an attempt to extend the time and space of English learning in different subjects. In 2007, the school entered the stage of CLIO multi-subject experiment, and bilingual teaching began to be experimented in six subjects, that is mathematics, science, art, Chinese and Western cultures, grammar, and PE. In 2017, it became the first school cooperating with the Shanghai Center for Research in English Language Education and developed the 4-in-1 characteristic courses under the guidance of the center. It includes National Basic English courses, Foreign Teacher English courses, CLIO courses, and Autonomous Extended English Reading courses. In 2018, the school carried out the research and the practice of task-based learning. Professor Rod Ellis, a renowned English linguist and expert in second language acquisition, has visited our school several times and had face-to-face communication with our teachers. Today, I'd like to share with you how our school responded to the COVID-19 pandemic and carry out online English teaching. I hope it would be helpful to you. In 2020, the coronavirus has resulted in schools shut all across the world. Globally, over 1.2 billion students were forced to leave the classroom or postpone their return to school. In 2021, as people felt that the pandemic seemed to come to an end, the virus returned with variant strains. As a result, education has changed dramatically with distinctive rise of e-learning. The traditional teaching scenes of schools were highly structured and unified no longer exist. The future learning scene of learning anytime and anywhere is approaching us quickly in an unexpected way. During the Spring Festival of 2020, in response to the pandemic, the Chinese Ministry of Education advocated suspending class without stopping learning and instructed schools to provide resources and support for students to study at home. But what resources should be provided and how should they be provided? Facing this big experiment of home learning, people raised various questions and came up with ideas. The topic has aroused extensive reflection and discussion in the education circle. As a common school, during the pandemic, the double teacher model of learning was implemented to the fullest effect so as to realize an effect of 1 plus 1 greater than 2. After the outbreak of the pandemic, the Chinese Ministry of Education quickly clarified the scientific connotation of suspending class without stopping learning. It does not refer to pure online education, nor does it only involve school curriculum learning, but it refers to a broad sense of learning. All content and methods are acceptable, as long as they can help students grow and make progress. which provided a basis for formulating local implementation plans across the country. The Ministry of Education also stressed that it's not necessary to require all teachers to record classes. Instead, we should make good use of the existing high-quality online courses, and students should not be forced to go online and clock in every day. According to the requirements of the Ministry of Education, Shanghai formulated an implementation model with online class and teacher-student interaction as the basic form. Different regions and schools are allowed to make strategies suiting their specific conditions. Liu Hui, associate professor in the Department of Curriculum and Learning Science at Zhejiang University, he believes that if we look at it from a discovery perspective, the situation we are forced to go through during this pandemic has also brought some new insights, enabling us to feel the school without boundaries. According to Zhang Zhiming, vice president of China Education Society and the chairman of Gezhi Education Group, he says it allows us to see the huge energy of large-scale, normalized implementation of online teaching, and also allows us to see the new model of future learning reform, showing the bright prospects of new education balance and education modernization. There are more than 200 million students and 10 million teachers in China. In the face of the initiative of the Ministry of Education and facing such a large-scale wave of teaching and learning at home, both teachers and students had many doubts in terms of hardware use, teaching design, effective teacher-student interaction, as well as question answering. This is indeed an innovative model that nobody had practiced before. Then how do we, the frontline teachers, overcome various crises in a way? The strategy we adopted was to be question-oriented and to address the questions and the potential problems most widely expressed by the teachers and the students. On that basis, the questions were solved one by one with the concerted effort of the teaching research team and the lesson preparation teams of different grades in the school. The questions were arranged according to the frequency that were raised by the teachers and the students. Here are the teachers' questions. Number one, I don't know how to teach online. What should I do? Number two, I can't use online recording equipment and education platforms. What should I do? Number three, the online classroom with videos is fast and there is little exercise of language knowledge. What if the students can't grasp the knowledge? Number four, what shall we do if some activities have to be organized face-to-face and we can't organize them during video teaching? Number 5. How should the students hand in the homework? Number 6. How should I correct students' homework and provide feedback? Number 7. How do I know if the students have really grasped the knowledge? Number 5. After the parents return to work, there is not enough supervision over the students. Are the students really studying on time? Let's take a look at the students' question. Number one, my parents are not at home. What if I don't have a fast internet connection and a computer fails? My grandma can't help me with it all. Number two, the online classroom is a little fast and too little time is given for refreshing and exercise. What should I do if I am forced to begin the next step before I complete the step before? Number 3. The homework assigned in the online classroom is way too easy. Number 4. I feel bored because I can't see my friends in online learning. Number 5. The questions raised by teachers in the online classroom are quite interesting, and I do want to express my opinions, but it feels awkward too because I am facing a TV set. Number six, our teachers are working so hard online. Can they get a raise? Very interesting question. It was found through the survey that the questions of the teachers are mainly in the following aspects. Number one, the use of online platforms. Number two, the learning content and students' grasp of the key points. Number three, the students' learning effect. And number four, cooperation of the parents. Number five, whether the students can reasonably arrange their time for learning and whether they can learn proactively. While the questions of the students are more diversified, mainly being their subjective feelings, which can be summarized as having difficulty in psychologically adapting to the new learning method during the pandemic. Through the survey, we found there are four main problems that need to be addressed. Number one, how to relieve the teachers and students' psychological and technical misgivings in online teaching. We found a common problem shared by the teachers and students is that they are not fully psychologically prepared for online teaching and learning. Particularly speaking, it's reflected in their difficulty in using electronic devices. Most teachers don't have the experience of teaching online, and it's somewhat of a challenge for older teachers and young students to operate computers and other electronic equipment used in online teaching. In response to these problems, the school provided a training in online operation for every teacher. The English teaching and research group adopted the method of pairing young teachers and older teachers, and provided guidance to teachers who needed special help on the basis of school-level training. We also made use of the advantages of the lesson preparation team of the grades to jointly develop teaching resources, and complicated operations were assigned to teachers with strong information technology skills, while older teachers were responsible for completing basic operations. In this way, the technical problems of online teaching were easily solved. For students, we try to simplify the requirements for equipment operation and use the learning platforms that students were already using, such as Xiaohuiban, Dingding, and the WeChat groups for interactions and learning guidance. The school also organized all parents and students to participate in online training to guide and help the students master the simple operations of online learning equipment, which relieved the misgivings of the students and their parents. The second question is how to carry out and implement online English learning. In the spring semester of 2020, the primary and secondary schools in Shanghai carried out the unified online classroom for online education of the city. The Municipal Education Commission organized more than 1,000 outstanding teachers in various schools and subjects in the city and asked them to record relevant course videos in accordance with the curriculum standards, covering all subjects in primary and secondary schools. The main four of the courses was TV broadcasting, with one channel for each grade, and the students could also watch the lessons through different terminals such as computers, tablets, and mobile phones. After the class, students could communicate and interact with the teachers of the school through Xiaohuiban, Dingding, or WeChat. In order to prevent the students' eyesight from worsening, the length of online recording lessons for primary school students was confined to a maximum of 20 minutes per lesson, and 5 to 6 lessons were provided per day. Teachers set up Q&A and discussion spaces online to provide targeted answers to the questions raised by the students. The instructional video designed by the online English classroom was for all schools in all districts of the city. The curriculum content was designed to be simple and easy to learn. The media materials were beautifully and vividly prepared, and the lecturers selected all had excellent teaching skills. However, even the best recorded lessons have shortcomings. For example, the teachers in the videos cannot interact with the students in a real and effective way, cannot assign homework according to students' abilities, and cannot detect the learning effect of students and provide feedback. In addition, they cannot answer students' questions. Therefore, in response to the above problems, we carried out a secondary lesson preparation based on the online English classroom. If we call the teachers in online English classroom the leading lecturers, the teachers responsible for the secondary lesson preparation can be called the assisting teachers. The teaching effect we achieved during the pandemic is the result of the in-depth cooperation between the two teachers. The assisting teachers designed assignments in a targeted manner, provided corrections and guidance, gave evaluations and incentives so as to maximize the effect of students' online English learning. So, how did the lesson preparation groups of the grades carry out the secondary lesson preparation? First, whether it is online or offline, and whether it is the leading lecturers or the assisting teachers. The first task was to clarify what to teach and what to learn. For example, the teachers from the English lesson preparation group of grade 2 carried out cloud teaching research, studying curriculum standards, analyzing textbooks and learning conditions, and on that basis, they created unit learning resources, considering the flexibility of online learning. The teachers in the lesson preparation group worked together. Mature teachers with rich teaching experience designed interactions and exercises according to the key and difficult points of the units, and consolidating in four dimensions: listening, speaking, reading, and writing, covering such contents as pronunciation, vocabulary, grammar, writing forms, and reading comprehension. Young teachers who are good at computer operations were responsible for the collection of related resources and the graphic design of homework to promote students' understanding and stimulate their interest in learning. The lesson preparation progress was generally 1 to 2 weeks ahead of the teaching progress of the online English classroom. Teachers of the same grade watched the video of the online English classroom 1 day in advance. After that, the teachers discussed and modified the content of the homework in a WeChat group, according to the teaching design of online classroom. The third question is how to design online English learning activities to stimulate students' interest in learning. In the past, students were able to interact with their teachers and classmates at school. During the pandemic, students' interpersonal communication reduced significantly. And as a result, their negative emotions were difficult to be properly channeled. In addition, the lack of outdoor activities was also detrimental to the physical and mental health of students. In response to these problems and different learning styles of the students, the teachers designed some interesting English learning activities that students could complete independently at home. For example, students were asked to choose a Spring Festival topic they were interested in to introduce, which could be telling stories related to the festival, organizing a traditional costume show, introducing the traditional customs of the festival, making or introducing a traditional delicacy. Student could also choose to grow a plant in spring at home, introduce the planting method and observe and record how the plant grew. We also encouraged students to present in the form they liked. They could make a small video, record a short speech, carefully prepare a report, tell a story to their friends. After that, students could choose to publish what they completed to the online English interactive communication space of the class. Some other teachers found that new students transferred to their class could not meet their new classmates since the students all delayed their return to school. In response to that, teachers designed the activity of talking about what I like through mind mapping, which not only showed the students what mind mapping was, but also helped introduce the new students to their classmates. In the meantime, students could also choose to read at home. During the study of each unit, teachers in the lesson preparation group would prepare two picture books with different difficulties according to the theme of the unit, or recommend and upload some classic English materials for extended reading, which the students could choose and download, making their language learning at home more colorful and comprehensive. Teachers in the lesson preparation group also prepared beautiful PPTs and audio files for these stories, which the students could easily read and follow with just a click. These diversified and interesting activities not only promoted students' English acquisition, but also relieved their anxiety caused by staying indoors for a long time during the pandemic, as well as the insecurity caused by the lack of social interaction. The fourth question is how to help the students and their parents solve the difficulties in online learning. During the pandemic, the parents of primary school students became the main force in urging the students to learn. In addition to completing work tasks, they had to supervise their children in learning, which put great pressure on them. While carrying out online teaching, we reminded our teachers to pay close attention to the students and their parents in the class, communicate with them in time, so as to find out the potential problems and give necessary help. So how did the teachers know about the problems and conditions in their students' home? The teachers made statistics and summarizes on the students' online interaction, the quality of homework, and the frequency of their participation in activities, and pay attention to the response of parents to the teachers' homework assignments and the replies to notifications. Through the correlation analysis of the parents' attention to the students' learning and the students' performance, Teachers managed to judge whether the students were studying well at home. According to relevant data, families can be divided into four types. Table 3 shows that in 59.8% of the families, the parents supervise the students strictly. They pay close attention to the studying requirements published by the teachers and their feedback about the students' learning performance. The students' performance was the same as that before the pandemic, and some of them even had better performance. Around 21.9% of the students were supervised loosely by their parents, but they studied quite proactively during the pandemic and had a great interest in studying, leading to good performance. However, about 10.5% of families were worrying. The parents didn't pay much attention to their children studying, and the students themselves lacked self-control, leading to unsatisfactory performance. In the other 7.8% of the families, the students' performance got worse and worse despite their parents' close attention to their studying, making the teacher wonder whether the parents were supervising the students properly, or maybe the students had great difficulties in study. On the basis of discussing and analyzing the above situation, we took the following follow-up measures. On the one hand, the teachers tried to figure out which knowledge points in each unit were well mastered by the students and which ones were difficult for the students, so as to provide further targeted guidance. As well as this, the teachers organized two online doubt-solving activities per week, in which the parents and the students could ask questions. And if they could not be online during these activities, they could leave a message in the activity area so that the teachers could answer afterward. Due to a variety of reasons, some parents were not staying in the same city as their children. In that case, teachers played the role of parents and often communicated with the students online to know their learning situation, detect problems in time, and help them. For students throughout China and around the world, 2020 may have been the most unforgettable year. We faced an unprecedented challenge, which all of us have our own stories to share. But there are opportunities in this crisis. Our concerted effort and popular wisdom have enabled us to cope with impact of the pandemic on traditional way of learning and maximize the effect of studying at home. From the announcement of the guideline policy by the Ministry of Education to the accurate deployment of specific work by the local government, and then to the introduction and implementation of the targeted strategies of schools in different districts. From the design and the recording of the online classroom to all teachers and students in the city opening their accounts in specified platforms. From online teaching training for all teachers and the students of the school to the formulation of study plans based on the municipal level courses, design and preparation of teaching materials, then to uploading studying resources, and finally meeting the students in the cloud. It only took us the winter holidays, that is 1 month. All these tasks were completed by teams in which all members worked with a clear divisions of labor and in a coordinated manner, which greatly improved our efficiency. From my personal perspective, I teach three classes in grade two, and some teachers have more classes than me, which means their workload is greater than mine. I made some rough statistics of my workload in the 5 months during the online teaching in the pandemic, as shown below. Thanks to the hard work of every educator involved in this process, our students were able to begin online learning normally. In the face of the pandemic, we didn't panic and we are not afraid of the challenges in front of us. Instead, we studied and discussed the problems, practiced and reflected, trying to find solutions so as to provide high quality for online teaching for all the students. During the pandemic, the Education Development Research Institute of Pudong New Area published the questions about online teaching and the guidelines for teaching. At the same time, district-level teaching research activities helped the teachers understand the guidelines and guided them in implementing correct teaching suggestions. District-level online teaching research was organized every 2 weeks, in which schools from different regions were invited to share their successful experience and communicate with other schools online. Guidance was provided for each lesson and each link of studying, so that we could learn from each other. Many problems were solved in this way. Advice from others may help one overcome one's own shortcomings. By learning from other schools and designing online teaching suiting themselves, the schools managed to get twofold results with half the effort. Here are some reflections on the post-pandemic era. It is gratifying that with the concerted efforts of all people, the pandemic in China has been effectively controlled, but scattered cases still occur from time to time. We dare not say that the future has come. After all, suspension of classes without stopping learning is an unusual state during an unusual period of time. It is just a short rehearsal of future learning. Many problems were exposed in this rehearsal. For example, large-scale online teaching during the pandemic has been a huge test on teachers' information literacy, and many teachers could not operate modern online teaching equipment. Secondly, online teaching was a test to the teachers' internal capacity. As the classroom was moved to the cloud, some teaching methods and strategies adopted before no longer worked, and the teachers had to react quickly and properly. Certainly, during the pandemic, the teachers' workload increased sharply. We managed to cope with this situation in a short time, but if we have to teach online for an extended period of time, our teaching resources and teaching strategies are far from enough to enable us to cope with it with ease. Currently, teaching in China has returned to the state before the pandemic. The hard times have passed, allowing us a space to take a breath and reflect. By studying what we did well in this rehearsal and the problems exposed during it, we are able to reflect on how we can better carry out online education in the future. A seamless connection of online and offline education truly represents the direction of education in the future, that is mixed learning. After we went through during this pandemic, all English teachers have begun to reflect on English teaching, and we are trying to integrate online learning in daily learning activities, so that we can interact more closely and frequently. Thus gradually reform our teaching model and conceive the way of English learning together with our students. Thank you for all your attention. You are welcome to contact me through this email address at any time.